What's up internet, welcome back once again. I'm Manish from rebellionrider.com. This is the second tutorial in iterative statement series. This tutorial will help you in learning the concepts of while loop in Oracle PL SQL. I would suggest you to watch the previous tutorial where we discussed the intro of loops and learned the concept of simple loop with example in PL SQL. That said, let's start today's tutorial. Concept of while loop is not new to the programming world and almost all the programming languages support this concept. While loop is not the exception to other loops. It also executes block of statements several times. But this loop is best usable when number of iterations to be performed are unknown. Let's first take a look at the syntax of while loop in PL SQL and then we will do the examples. Unlike other complex programming languages, the syntax of while loop in PL SQL is comparatively easy. The keyword while marks the beginning of the loop followed by the word condition, which will serve your test condition, which will get evaluated either to be true or to be false. And at the end of our first line, we have another keyword which is loop. The statements 1 through n are sequence of executable statements which define the body of the loop. And at the end, we have our result phrase end loop, which indicates the ending of the while loop. In order to execute the body of the loop, the test condition needs to be true. If this condition is evaluated to be true, then control will jump inside the loop and execute whatever statements it has. This iteration will continue until the test condition becomes false. As soon as the test condition is evaluated to be false, the control will come out of the loop and execute the statement which immediately followed the loop. Since the while condition is evaluated before entering the loop, therefore it is possibility that the loop body may not execute at all. Hope this made the concept of while loop clear to you. Now let's do some examples. Today we will do two examples. In the first example, we will print the multiplication table of 19 again using while loop. And in the second example, we will see how to handle boolean variable in test condition of a while loop. So let's start with our first example. In the previous tutorial, we did the same example and required to write few extra line of codes to terminate the loop using exit and exit when clause. However, with while loop, we do not need that. It will terminate as soon as the test condition becomes false. In this example, we have declared two variables, v underscore counter, which will serve as a counter, and variable v underscore result, which will hold the result of multiplication. Down in the execution section, we have our while loop. The first statement inside the loop body is an arithmetic expression which will perform the multiplication of our table and will store the result in v underscore result variable. Second statement is an output statement which will print the result of the multiplication in a formatted manner. And the third statement is an update statement which will update the counter with each iteration. This while loop will keep on iterating until the counter is less than 10 or it becomes equal to 10. Once the value of the counter becomes 10, the while loop will terminate and execute the first statement immediately outside the loop body. This in our case is our last DBMS underscore output statement. So let's execute and see the result. And here is our multiplication table of 19. Now, let's do the second example and see how to handle boolean expression as the test condition. For the demonstration, I will write a very simple code which will print the counting from 1 to 10. But before that, let's close this script output and clear the screen. Again in this program, I have declared two variables v underscore test and v underscore counter. The variable v underscore test is of boolean type and we set its value to true. This boolean variable will serve as our test condition in the while loop. The second variable is just a counter whose value we are going to print. Down in the execution section, we have our while loop. As you can see, the variable v underscore test is working as a test condition here for this loop. As its value is set to true, thus it makes our loop iterate until its value changes and set to false. Unfortunately, this isn't going to happen by itself. Hence, we will have to write a code for that, otherwise it will become an infinity loop. Anyways, let's move ahead. The first statement of this loop is an arithmetic expression which will increment the counter by 1 on each iteration of the loop. In the second statement, we are simply printing the value of our v underscore counter variable. Then we have the end loop followed by another output statement. The thing about Boolean expression in loop is that we have to write the code which will change its value to false and terminate the loop. Failing to do so can make your loop an infinity loop. In our program, we haven't written that code, which means that if we execute this program, then the execution will keep on printing till we halt it manually. So let's add that code. Just add this if-then block right before the ending of the loop. Now, as soon as the counter will become equal to 10, the value of v underscore test will change and set on false, which will terminate the loop. So let's execute. And here is the counting from 1 to 10. Now, I want you to write a program which will print the multiplication table of 19 or any other number using Boolean expression. For hints, you can refer to my blog on the same topic. Hope you enjoyed watching. Please give this video a thumbs up. Also, help your friend learning the concept by sharing this video with them, or you can share this video on your social. More importantly, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll be back soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.